that we can hold on to is the Christ in us. The Bible says is the hope of glory. Praise the Lord. The Bible says, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. You are not looking unto the news, because the news is not encouraging. Somebody give the Lord a shout. The news is not encouraging. When you see, if it started from 1,000 to about 52,000 of human beings, we're not talking about stones here. We are talking about humans like me and you. 52,000 people has gone down the rain just like that because of coronavirus. Somebody shout hallelujah. So it is dangerous for you to be disconnected in this time that we are. In John chapter 15, my Bible tells me, it says Jesus is staying right here. It says, I am the vine and ye are the branches. Can you be disconnected from your vine? If you are the branches, can you be disconnected from your vine? You are not going to be fruitful when you are disconnected from your source. Somebody say to your neighbor around you, in your home, in your family, in the church, say, stay connected, neighbor. Say, stay connected to your source. Praise the Lord. He says, I am the vine and ye are the branches. He said, he that abided in me and I in him. He said, the same fruit bring forth fruit. And for without me, ye can do nothing. Praise the Lord. Without Christ in us, we can do nothing. Without Christ, we become more vulnerable. Praise the Lord. Without Christ in us, we become vulnerable to the devil. Praise the Lord. So we have to know that this is not the time to play church. It is not the time to play this. It is time for you to arise and glue to your maker. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In John chapter 15 tells us that there is no way, it is dangerous. If you plant a seed on the ground and when it germinates and you are the root of that seed that you planted, and you have other branches around it. When you uproot everything, both the branches, what are you going to gain? Praise the Lord. So it is dangerous for you to be disconnected at this time. Somebody say to your neighbor, say, neighbor, say, stay connected. Hallelujah. In Psalm 18, the Bible still says the same thing. The Bible says, is there once have I spoken? See, the word of God is so powerful. When you hear it in Genesis, you will still hear it in Jeremiah. If you are not careful, you will still hear it in Revelation. You will see it in the book of John. Praise the Lord. He said, once have I spoken, twice have I heard that power belongs to God. He's still saying here in Psalm 18, verse 29. He said, for by thee, he's talking about God now. For by thee, I have run through a troop, and by my God, I have leaped over a wall. So you see that? So we can do nothing without Christ. So without me, you can do nothing. By God, we can leap over war. By God, in this period that we are, we can leap over war. Praise the Lord. For the past few weeks now, I leaned so much on God. I leaned so much on him. And he held me so I could not fall. Praise the Lord. We can do nothing. For by him, we run through a troop. For by him, we conquered that Goliath. For by him, we were able to stand in this season of pandemic. Praise the Lord, my brethren. I want to bring to you that the story of 2020, when we are all telling the story, you will be among those that will tell the story in the name of Jesus. Oh, we will not say, oh, he died in the war. He died among those that were counted for coronavirus. Praise the Lord. But you will live and you will tell your children the story about 2020. In Numbers chapter 31, verse 49 now, that when the servants of Moses, when they came, they look around and they said, our servant, our master, Moses, we have counted, we are taking census, we have counted everybody, and none of the soldiers that went for the war, none of them were missing. I make a decree that you will not be missing in the name of Jesus. He said, none of them were missing. I make a decree that you and your family, you will not be missing in the name of Jesus. In verse 50 of that, something happened that me and you will partake of. Praise the Lord. Me and you will partake of what happened in Numbers chapter 31, verse 50. In verse 50 now, he said, and they came all together with offerings, with gold, with different kind of blessing, ornaments, and everything that you can think about. And they came to the house of the Lord, praising God. Who is ready to experience that? Wherever you are, shout hallelujah. Yeah. together to the house of the Lord to give him praise. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In Luke chapter 9, verse 62, and Jesus said unto him, no man having put his hands to the plow and look back. No man having put his hands to the plow and look back is fit for the kingdom. Praise the Lord. This is not time for you to look back. This is not time for you to say, God, where are you? Yes, God is in heaven. He is seated upon the throne and he rules and reigns in the affairs of his people. And he does whatever that pleases him. Praise the Lord. It is not time for you to ask questions. It is time for you to enter your war room and lock up yourself. Praise the Lord. It is time for you to look unto Jesus. It is time for you to look unto him. Remember, when there is storm, after the storm is over, there is always a story. Praise the Lord. You remember that? When a storm comes, when the storm is over, there is always a story. Without a story, there can't be a glory. Some of us just want to experience glory. We don't want to experience story. Praise the Lord. You have to have a story for you to have a glory. Praise the Lord. Your story, when you go through story, you are going through the things that have hurt you so much in life. And when you step into the realm of glory, you are giving God praise. Somebody shout hallelujah. Without pain, there can't be gain. Hallelujah. We are going through pain right now. We're going through pains because we can't go out. We can't do the things that we used to do. But this is a wake-up calling for us. For us to know that everything that matters to us does not matter to God. Praise the Lord. The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and every other thing shall be added unto it. We have turned the Bible upside down. What we are seeking first is every other thing, and we leave the kingdom of God aside. But this time is a time for us to seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these things that they are taking away from us will be added. If you have on my Instagram page, if you have a private jet, you can't fly it now. You can't fly it. You have so much clothes now, you can't go to church. Is it not church that we come? You can't wear all those, your Coach and your Gucci and everything. We can't, where do you want to go? You want to wear them to the mall, as clothes as well. You want to wear it to your children's school, the school, everything has been shut down. God is showing us that he is all that matters. We don't matter. There is nothing in the world that makes sense. God is the only one that truly makes sense. And without him in your life, as many of us of you watching me online, if you have not given your life to Christ, this is the time to do it. Tomorrow might be too late. The Bible says it is not of the will of God that any man perish, but come to repentance. Praise the Lord. It is a time to be closer to God. It is a time for you to disconnect yourself from the world. The world has proven to you that they cannot offer you anything. It is a time for you to disconnect yourself from the world and connect yourself to the Word. Do you hear that? Disconnect yourself from the world. WORLD. Disconnect yourself from the world and connect yourself to the Word. WORLD. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We are not playing church anymore. This is the time to wake up. When Adam and Eve, when they disconnected themselves from God, they began to experience shame. They were naked because they got disconnected from their maker. In Genesis chapter 3, verse 7, the Bible talks about how Adam and Eve, how God created them in a beautiful place, and he made provisions for them. He made sure they did not lack anything. He provided everything for them in the Garden of Eden. But Satan still came and he messed with their mind. This time I want to encourage you, do not let your mind be messed up. Do not let your mind be polluted because of what is going on. The Bible says the righteous are as bold as lions. This time I want you to be bold. Be bold in everything that you do. When they are saying there's a casting down, be saying there's a lifting up. Come on, you will open your mouth in your family and say, in this house, we are not permitted to experience any evil. Praise the Lord. You have to be people. people of the world. You have to be those who digest the word of God. Don't be weary with what is going on around you. Praise the Lord. You have to desire God. Adam and Eve got disconnected, and all they could experience in their life was shame. Praise the Lord. Those who stay connected to God, they will always draw. Somebody say draw. Somebody say draw now. If you're online, say draw. Those who stay connected to God, they will always draw strength from the rivers of the living waters. Those who stay connected to God, the Bible says the righteous man falleth 7 times, but will rise again. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Those who draw strength, those who stay connected to God, they will continue to draw strength from the rivers of the living waters. It is time to desire God, brethren. It is not time for your faith to be weary. It is time to desire Him. Hold on to Him. Hold on to Him. No storm, no soil. If you don't have storm, you can. I had my storm a few weeks ago. I had my storm. It was so terrible. I thank God for my beloved husband and all my children. But this is my story. I am standing here in His presence. This is my story. Praise the Lord. Without a storm, you can't have your own story. I had my storm, and now I'm telling my story. Praise the Lord. You will tell the story of your life, not in a bad way, in a good way, in the name of Jesus. In Matthew chapter 24, verse 12 now and 13, he said, "And because iniquity shall abound," he said, "the love of many will wax cold." Don't let your love wax cold. That was why I sang that song. I sat down there, and the Holy Spirit dropped that song in my spirit. More love, more power, more of you in my life. And I was like, God, you want that song to be connected to this message. It just dropped it in my spirit right there. Praise the Lord. "And the love of many will wax cold." He said, "But he that endureth to the end shall be saved." If you can endure in this period of pandemic, you will be saved because the Lord has spoken. Praise the Lord. Do not let your love be terminated. Don't terminate your love for Christ. Don't say, "Where is the God that we have been calling?" If you read your Bible very well, there's a man called King Jehoshaphat in 2 Chronicles now, I think verse 20. He called upon the Lord. Just what is happening right now, when so many nations, when they rose up against him, he called upon the name of the Lord, and the Lord stood up. The Lord told him, he said, "Step aside. Step aside." Before the Lord told him to step aside, they began to worship. Somebody is going to war, and you don't have all your gadgets and everything. The only thing you are going to is your choir. And I want to thank all of you, our choir. May the Lord bless you. In this season, you have been so faithful. You have been so committed to your calling. And I pray that the Lord will bless you. The Lord will enlarge your territory in the name of Jesus. Your leader that is pushing you people together, the Lord will uphold him in the name of Jesus. I was whispering to pastors here this morning when I got in. And I was like, "Oh my God, this choir, they're just so amazing." The Lord bless every one of you in the name of Jesus. Your reward is not just going to be in heaven. You will enjoy your reward from here. And you, when you get to heaven, you will enjoy more of it in the name of Jesus. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8. He said, "Be sober. Brethren, be sober. Christians, be sober. Be vigilant. Because your adversary, who is the devil, is running around seeking who he may devour." Somebody was saying that coronavirus, when people get healed, there's still something that drops in them. That devil is the bastard. Somebody will get healed and it will still drop something in them. Praise the Lord. The Bible says, "By his stripes we are healed." Nothing will remain. Praise the Lord. "And I make a decree that as many that have been affected, wherever they are, that the Lord begin to perfect their healing in the name of Jesus." We release the balm of Gilead right now, wherever they are. And we decree that they begin to be saved in the name of Jesus. Be sober, children of God, and be vigilant. Because the devil, who is our adversary, is roaming around seeking who he may devour. Praise the Lord. Seeking who he may devour. If we are steadfast in our faith, no affliction can come near us. Praise the Lord. No affliction. Be steadfast in your faith. Be steadfast in your faith. In that, First Peter chapter 5, in verse 9 of it, he said, "But you, who resist and be steadfast in faith," he said, "knowing that the same affliction are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world." Is it not everyone that is going through this? Both Christians, we've heard of pastors that die. So many people. But if you are connected to your source, you have to hold God by his word. We don't know how to hold God by his word. When I got when my storm came a few weeks ago, I told God, I said, "God, I just sent something into the world. I said, I call you healer. I call you master. And I said, God, I cannot call you healer. I cannot write a song and say, you are my healer. I cannot write a song and say, oh Jesus, your name is powerful. Oh Jesus, your name is glorious. Oh Jesus, you heal the sick, you raise the dead. Oh Jesus, there is power in your name, and we call you Jesus. Oh Jesus, oh Jesus, for your name is great. For your name, oh God, is great. For your name is great and greatly to be praised." I call you master, master, master. That's who you are. And I call you Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh. Somebody say, that's who you are. I call you my healer. And God came powerfully 3 times. And the stream of healing begin to flow. Amen. It begin to flow. My God, oh, praise the Lord. Rise on your feet wherever you are. Shakataya baba. Masokolaba yandaraba. Sharaba karebo sharababa. Wherever you are in your home, lift up your hands. Lift up your hands and make a decree. And say, Father, help me to stay connected to you. Help me, oh God, in this season to stay connected to you. Help me to be strong, oh God. Help me not to fall on the wayside. Help me, oh God. Uphold me with your right hand. Uphold me with your right hand. Brethren, quickly, praise the Lord. I want to tell you, in this period, do not follow the crowd. Be mindful of that. Don't follow the crowd, but follow Christ. Somebody say that. Don't follow the crowd, but follow Christ. Don't follow the crowd, follow Christ. Lift up your hands and say, Father, say, Father, in this period that we are, help me to stand strong in the name of Jesus. Help me to be stay connected to you. Help me not to be disconnected, oh God. Help me and my family to stay strong in you. Help us, oh God, to overcome. The Bible says Christ has come and he has overcome the world for us. Open your mouth and say, Father, help me to stay connected. Help me to be strong in you. Help me, oh God, let my bones carry fire. Let my body carry fire. Let my bones carry fire. Fire that coronavirus cannot touch. In the name of Jesus, fire that coronavirus cannot touch. I plead mighty name of Jesus. We refuse to follow the crowd. We refuse to follow the crowd. And we are connected to you forever and ever. Our Savior and the Bishop of our soul. We glorify your name. Somebody bless the name of the Lord. Wherever you are, just give him praise. Give him praise. He's worthy to be praised. He's not a man that will lie. Neither the son of man that will repent of his words. Father, we bless you, O God. We glorify you. We honor you, O God, in our life. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Wherever you are in your home, I just want you to bless the Lord. Come on, bless the Lord. Come on, bless the Lord. The psalmist said, bless the Lord, O my soul. And all that is within me, bless his holy name. We give you praise, O God. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.